With the NRL and the AFL in the midst of their own drug scandal, the Australian Olympic Committee has announced how it plans to tighten up its own anti-doping code. The new policy means athletes must cooperate with ASADA and any who will refuse will face tough penalties. Our reporter Antoinette Latouf is in Sydney Olympic Park for us tonight. Antoinette, will today's announcement do much to deter drug cheats?
Well, the move has been described as groundbreaking, and athletes now have a choice. They can remain tight-lipped about their own drug use or a teammate's drug use, but if they do that, they'll simply be kicked off the Olympics team.
Being an Olympian is one of the highest honours for an athlete, and now they'll be the most highly scrutinised. It's a bid to end athletes making headlines for all the wrong reasons.
In the past few months have been a very difficult time for many sports fans.
The new rules announced today at the Australian Olympic Committee's annual meeting require athletes to answer doping questions truthfully, providing all relevant information, even if it incriminates them, or else they'll be sacked from the Olympic team.
Well, the AOC changes announced today are groundbreaking because it will ensure that the code of silence in the locker room about drugs in sport will now be broken.
And it's this code of silence that's stalling Australia's anti-doping agency's investigation into the NRL's Cronulla Sharks. Interviews are being abandoned over a legal argument about how much an athlete is obliged to say. It's exactly this the AOC wants to avoid.
The AOC have been lobbying for a tougher stance on drugs in sport as far back as 2000, and while today's announcement makes some progress, they'd still prefer to put drug cheats behind bars.
That if it's good enough to support the integrity of our financial markets with criminal penalties, it's equally critical to support and protect the integrity of sports.
But for now, the government supports a $5,500 fine, but not jail time. The AOC is also calling on other sporting codes and institutions to come down harder on its drug cheats.
And the federal government has just committed an additional $3.5 million to anti-doping bodies, and they hope to extend ASADA's powers. Now, ASADA is the chief anti-doping agency, and they hope to extend their powers to allow them to coerce athletes to talk. Now, that bill will be presented to Parliament and debated in the next couple of months.
Antoinette, thank you.